Yeah, I was so confused. I just don't know. I don't know. So, and then you have food there too.
Absolutely. We have a full menu. Kind of.
You have a lot of bacon.
We do have a lot of bacon. We also have a lot of vegan and vegetarian items.
Yeah.
We're all about choice.
Yeah. In fact, some of your menu items seem to indicate that. Like you have a sandwich called the Polly.
We do. We have a little sheet that you can fill out with all your different menu choices for building your own sandwich, and we say build your sandwich relationship the way you want to.
And do you have one called the Monogamy?
We do not have one called the Monogamy, but we have several sandwiches on the menu that are set, and that's what you get. So there you go.
So you could order the same thing over and over again if you wanted to.
You absolutely could.
Yeah, I got in that rut with the Polly for a while, but then I went with the Farmer's Daughter one time, and I've been kind of sleeping with the Farmer's Daughter ever since.
The Farmer's Daughter is pretty attractive.
It was so good, yeah. So is everything up to speed now as far as with opening? There was a time where the air conditioning, there was different, like is there always something happening
always
that you're always
something, yes.
having to deal with?
I worked in restaurants for the first part of my adult career, and I worked it as everything from the busboy up to the maitre d' and everything in between, and I thought I knew what I was getting into, and let me tell you, when you open it up and you own it yourself, there's a whole new level out there I wasn't expecting. So yeah, there is always something to be done, and I would say we're about 80% right now. We've still got a whole bunch of stuff that we need to do. We've got the parking lot improvement coming. We've got a beautiful big sign that we haven't been able to hang outside yet because we had to wait for a sign permit from the city. Mm-hmm. And we've got that beautiful big sign, the permit for that now, and that's going to get installed sometime in the next week. Mm-hmm. We've got the entrance hallway that comes into the building is still pretty rough and looks like the entrance to a big industrial building, and we're working on that to make that all pretty. We've got a little stage that's going to be going into the coffee
house. I was wondering where the stage is, because mm-hmm. I want to be on it.
It's going to be right when you come in the door. Mm-hmm. There's that corner that goes over to the windows there, and we're going to build a triangular stage that kind of goes right into that corner over there. It's large enough for about, maybe a three-piece acoustical trio.
Okay.
And then we're going to have live music and poetry readings and
spoken word,
yeah.
Okay, we're just about out of time. Okay, so I wanted to ask you about the fact that Shameless Grounds is family friendly.
Mm-hmm.
Kids come in there.
Absolutely, they love the chalkboard wall.
And so they play there, and that's fine. Mm-hmm. And they're just not allowed in the library. That's the 18 and up area.
Whether or not that's fine, we think is up to their parents. The library is 18 and over. We cannot allow them in there. Simply because there is pornography in there, there is mm-hmm. adult material in there, and by statute, we don't want to get in trouble, we don't want the community to become upset with us, so yeah, kids are not allowed in the library, but all the art, all of the, everything that goes on in the main space is sensual, mm-hmm. But not explicit,
mm-hmm.
and it's family friendly as long as your views on sensuality are family friendly.
So you might want to go there without kids first and scope it out.
Sure, sure.
And then maybe bring the kids back and it's fine.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
We have kids in there on a regular basis and it's some of the most fun because like I said, they love the chalkboard wall. They're running all over the place, having fun, carpet picnics.
And so how did the kids get here?
How did the kid? Yeah, I don't know. Stork, Cabbage Patch.
Yeah, what? Is that what happened?
I think so. Yeah.
Oh, okay, because no one had sex to have the
Nobody
kids,
had,
right? Because
no.
That'd be weird.
That would.
You know, we won't talk about that now. In fact, we're out of time, so we're just gonna cut it off right here, and I'm gonna go to break, and I'll be right back. So thank you so much, Andy, for coming on tonight.
Thank you so much for having
and
me.
And I would like to come do the show at Shameless Ground sometime.
That would be awesome.
Okay.
We'd
All right.
Love
that. We'll talk about that.
Okay.
Okay. Thanks.
You're welcome.
All right. Let's go to break.
Say it loud, uh-huh.
So, oh, hi, we're back, and Andy just got a lot more beautiful. No, this is not a makeover show, I'm just kidding. Okay, so I want to introduce our next guest. This is Holly, and she is the store manager of Spanky's, which is an adult toy store here in St. Louis.
Yes, it is. It's in Bridgeton, and then we also have a location in Fenton. And Fenton location is just a little bit of the both stores, like, combined, the video and the gift store. It's a little both of them combined. Mm-hmm. So,
okay. Yeah.
Location.
So, how long have you been working at an adult toy store?
I've been working there 6.5 years.
Really?
Well, 6.5 years in April, so it's a little bit longer, but...
What's a nice girl like you doing in a toy store like that?
Well, what happened when, like, my best friend, we were, like, sitting there, it was, like, midnight, and we were, like, what is there to do, you know, and... So she was like, how about we go to the store? You know, my best friend's kind of a freak, so, you know, how about we go to the store? And I was like, okay, that sounds great. You know, we go into Spanky's, and I was like, oh, this is awesome, you know? And my ex-manager, she left to have babies and stuff, but she was working, and she was like, oh, you would be a great addition. And at the time, I was like, you know, in between jobs and, like, you know, trying to get myself back in order and maybe a job while I go to school or something like that, but...
Okay,
you know, I just started.
So I've been,
it was amazing.
I've been to sex toy stores several times, and no one's ever offered me a job.
Really?
Yeah. Like what?
I think that they were just like looking for someone, and like she was the only girl that worked there, so she was like, "I need another woman in the store."
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
Like,
so
Spanky's was predominantly male.
Spanky's. It sounds a little bit like Hustler. It sounds Spanky's.
Well,
it
see,
sounds...
that's the thing. It's like I have gone over, like, trying to, like, change it to be, like, a more woman-friendly, like, maybe even, like, not change the name because they like to keep the name. It's been that way since 1968, and
whoa.
So, yeah, it's, like, a big deal.
Mm-hmm.
And so maybe changing the coloring to, like, something a little more girly or something like that, making it more women-friendly.
Mm-hmm.
That's been my main goal. It's just hard to work with a bunch of men, so.
So how long have you been able to... rein your store as far as, well, I went in one day and Holly gave me a tour and I felt like she was the queen giving me a palace tour.
I am. It's my, that's my, like, my place. That's like, I am the queen of that store.
I've
been there. It's like home.
She was like Laura Bush and she was showing me the library and she's
Bush.
Like, I'm going to show
great.
You.
yeah, it was amazing. It's been an amazing journey. Like, I started when I was 22, and so I was, like, young and naive, and, like I met my husband right when I started working there, and I was, like, you know, back then I was, like, scared to tell people where I work, you know, didn't want to tell my husband's family where I worked and stuff like that, but eventually it got out, and I have just this strong support system that, like, you don't find usually, so everybody's, like, very, you know, they call me when they need something, and it's just great.
Oh, my gosh. So people respect you.
Yeah. I think it's just because I'm so open. I'm very laid back and open, and anybody can talk to me about anything, and so it's, like, it's just awesome.
Wow.
Yeah.
Oh, gosh.
And I started whenever the economy was, like, booming a lot better, you know, and so, like...
Uh-huh.
Our, you know, our teammates would just be like, you know, because back then I was just a regular employee, and so
mm-hmm.
we would, like, compete to see who did more, you know, each shift, and it was just fun,
yeah.
You know, and now the economy's kind of lulled a little bit, but we're still trying to, like, be out there and stuff like that. It's just getting your name out is a little bit hard right now.
Okay, and tell me again where Spanky's is, the one you work at, is in St.
It's in Bridgeton.
Bridgeton.
It's off of Lindbergh.
Uh-huh.
If you know where Northwest Plaza is, the deserted mall. That's
what happened.
I guess the economy. I guess. I mean,
oh my gosh. It's
that's what everybody blames. So I'm just gonna go with it. So
okay.
I mean, I don't know.
Okay. So yeah. So do you like North County?
It's okay. I mean, a lot of people think it's kind of like kind of dangerous, but it's not really like.
I wouldn't say
like,
it's
I grew
dangerous.
Up pretty much in North County, not North County. Maryland Heights, and
mm-hmm.
then there's Bridgeton.
Mm-hmm.
It was all, I went to Pattonville.
Well,
course.
It is dangerous with the tornado. Oh, my
yeah,
God.
The tornado. I know you drove through, and you were like, oh, my God. Yeah. Yeah, it is dangerous. Like, pretty much my whole, like, hometown pretty much got destroyed, but my family were okay, so that's okay.
Yeah,
it sucks for everybody else. We
I
did.
Know.
At Spanky's, we tried to do, like, a little, like, if you had something to donate, bring it to me, because... I knew a lot of people that were doing the donations, so I took them in and stuff
yeah,
like
I
that.
Think iWatch did that as well.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Oh,
anybody
man.
That can help at all is great right now.
Yeah, well, it sounds like Shameless Grounds is a wonderful community place. Have you been there?
Yeah, I have not. I want
okay.
to be
okay, well, that's because it's in South City.
I actually
and you're
this
representing.
Was done there.
Oh, yeah.
I you talk to me about it.
We
so.
Should.
Yeah,
we should
go.
Definitely be doing some on location there. But so you're representing NOCO. And that's just...
I mean, we also have a store in Fenton, but that's kind of like our combined store. We have, at my location, we have a store dedicated to toys and then a store dedicated to videos. And so it kind of makes it easier for women to come in and talk to me and stuff like that, because they don't have to go in where the arcade is and, you know, all the dirty videos, you know. But that's the thing, is like, once you come in and you talk to me, you know, if you ask me of a porn that's good, I'll let you know what I like. And like, a lot of females don't really know, you know. So I'm like, I like this one. It's a little bit, you know, more soft, or, you know, I know. So I know what to tell people or whatever, you know, what genre.
So what do you like?
I like Jenna Jameson and stuff, Vivid.
So you like, what is it called? Not amateur porn, but...
I like pretty girls. Like lipstick girls, you know, like... Pretty much, that's what I like.
And with storylines, or...?
Not really. Okay. Usually that gets fast-forwarded, so... Yeah. But I do know the ones that are, like, kind of more storyline and stuff like that, so I can kind of, like, judge by what they tell me what they want. I can tell them, you know, go into the video store, or I'll take them in there, and look for this, you know, and the clerks know exactly where everything is, and they know, so they'll direct them in the right way.
And there is an arcade?
There is. There's an arcade in the video store, yeah. Pretty much you put dollar bills in, and then you watch 60 minutes of porn.
How many minutes?
Or 60, yeah, 60 minutes.
6-0?
I think so. 60 minutes?
Well, that seems a long
time. I don't know. I need to be schooled in the video store.
Well, that's not your
Yeah, but in my store, basically, my main goal is to make people feel comfortable. You know, a lot of women will come in. I've had women come in that are like 50 and have never had an orgasm before, and it like breaks my heart. You know, it really does, just because, like, you could totally be, you know, relieving stress. And, you know, it's just, it makes you feel, like, a lot more liberated.
It's like free antidepressant. Yeah, my gosh.
Totally. Yeah.
So, like, have you had success stories of women who you've counseled them?
Yeah, like, I've had girls that come in that have tried vibrators, tried this, just nothing works for them. Like, their clitoris may be a little bit smaller or hard to get to, so I'm like, let's go to the Hitachi. I'm sure you've heard of the Hitachi.
Oh, yeah.
It's like, yeah. It's like the clit banger, you know what I mean? Like, if that doesn't help you, then, you know, we'll try that and some clitoral gel or something like that, because there's got to be something, or we could try G-spot or something.
Well, you know what I've learned with my whole Beautiful Kind thing is I've learned that some women don't know to fantasize for real. Like, they don't, like, I have this fantasy Rolodex that I flip through, and I'll find something and I'll go with it. And some women are just sitting there waiting for something to happen, but I like to, or read some erotica with it, or watch something.
Totally. Like, I read the Anne Rice, the erotic novels. Like, I'll read it for like 10 minutes, and then I'll have to put it down and, like, do my thing, and then, you know, start